Hi there, Diederik again, and let's get you started with your gum inspect suite. In this getting started video, we'll be teaching you how to make additional alignments in gum inspect suite. Feel free to pause, like always, at any point to follow along, and there's also chapter segments if you wish to skip ahead. Let's get started. To show you how we can make additional alignments in gum inspect suite, we'll start from this project. As you can see here in the top right corner, I already made this pre-alignment. Remember, that's this global best fit we talked about before. And in this global best fit, I can see some deviations on my part. But let's say that here, this middle area, where I see some larger deviations right here, I want to take this as a reference. And for this, I'll create a local best fit. To make this local best fit, I take my mesh file. I take one of the selections here at the bottom. In this case, I'll take the plane-based selection, because this plane-based selection allows me to select these three areas, or these three planes, and now use these for the local best fit. To show you the change, I'll also show the cat file. And the moment I make this local best fit, you'll see the mesh change its orientation. There, it happened. So doing this, automatically the software recalculates all my inspections. For example, the surface comparison I've made before now completely looks different, as this whole area is now green, which makes sense, as this was my key area that I used for the alignment. But obviously this pushes most of these high deviations to the away from that part here in the corner. The fact that now I have a local best fit doesn't mean that my pre-alignment, my global best fit, is no longer available. Look here in the Explorer, I still have my pre-alignment that I can easily drag and drop. It'll activate this pre-alignment and go back to that stage. So very easily I can toggle between these alignments. Next to this, I want to show you one more main alignment, a reference point system alignment, an RPS alignment. Let's take the cat file, look at some points that I've made before, some RPS points that you see right here. These 6 points I can add into my RPS dialog box. Create alignment, RPS. As you can see, it automatically selects the direction in which they will be used. This RPS is added now as a third alignment, which obviously I can easily restore and look at now also the effect. Let's look again at the surface comparison in this RPS alignment, which is now showing me again a different picture. And what is also nice is if I would look at these RPS elements, but also their deviation, obviously now they are 0 because I use them in the RPS alignment, and I would judge my part here very bad. But look what happens if I go to my pre-alignment. I can validate whether my RPS datum features are the right ones to use, or if I should adjust some, because here, for example, this RPS point is in a very weak spot. So it might be easier to fix this instead of only the results I see in my RPS alignment. This is it. I showed you how to make additional alignments, how to easily switch between these alignments, but also what the added value is of playing with these multiple alignments to see the effect of using one reference versus the other, and how to then optimize your part in the most efficient way. If you experience anything different from what you've seen here, or you have any questions or issues with your gum inspect suite, like always, reach out to us via support@hands-onmetrology.com. For more getting started information, check out the other videos as well. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.